Dolly Parton's 9 to 5 topped music charts in the 80s and got the singer an Oscar nod and 2 Grammy wins. Now, the 9 to 5 musical, inspired by Dolly's song and the hit movie of the same name, will finally be playing in Australia after the pandemic dared to interrupt production back in 2020. And joining us in the studio are the three leading ladies, Marina Prior, Erin Clare and Casey Donovan. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's so good to have you all here. Now, the show was a smash hit on London's West End.
Yes.
And Dolly's personality really shines through. So, Marina, how would you describe the musical for those who maybe haven't seen the movie?
It's joyful, it's hilarious, it's inspirational. It's very much about gal pals and sort of female empowerment. And it has 3 female protagonists, and we're not playing the love interest or the mum or the whoever. We're actually these 3 strong women who band together, and I love that.
That is a rare thing.
It is a really rare thing in anything, in movies, in musicals, you know, so it's fantastic to see. And we're so excited to just get back into it.
Yay!
Are we not? We've been sort of COVIDed for so long.
We're over COVID.
We're way over COVID.
Casey, how similar is the stage show to the movie?
Look, it's quite different, actually. There's a lot more funnies and there's a lot more, you know, in-depth into characters, which is great. I play
Jane Fonda.
Thank you. I was going to say June. but I'm Judy, currently, in the show. Jane Fonda. And I love Judy's role. It's just so intricate and, you know, born thinking that she's just going to grow up, be a wife and, you know, have kids and do the whole stay-at-home mum thing. But no, the husband goes off with the secretary and she's got to go and get a job and, you know, finds these 3 ladies and they all band together and get up to a bit of mischief, but also, yeah, change the way work happens.
Yeah, exactly right. Now, Erin, you've starred in some huge musicals like Phantom of the Opera and Heathers.
Mm-hmm.
Do you feel any pressure when you're playing a character that Dolly became so notable for?
I think when you play a character that's so iconic and it's so iconically Dolly, even though it's not Dolly, everyone says, oh, are you being Dolly in the Dolly musical? I think it's exciting because she's larger than life and I feel like playing her in a musical is so fitting. She should be in a musical. I mean, her hair alone is larger than life.
Have you got some kind of wig that's going to be
extraordinary? Yes, it's amazing. It looks gorgeous,
I love it. Casey, you touched on this, but the themes of gender equality that were so prevalent in the original film, do you think they're still resonating today? And if so, what does that say about us? We haven't moved forward that much.
Look, you know, it's a slow process. You know, it was a movie ahead of its time, and I think women now, in today's day and age, we're certainly being heard and we're pushing forward and banding together, and I think it is a slow and steady race. It should be a bit quicker, but, you know, our voices are being heard and we are being taken seriously because, you know, we are a force to be reckoned with and we come in hard and strong, and I think it's just about listening and hearing and moving forward and really just, getting it done because it's 2021 and we've gone through a lot in the last few years on everything.
And this is such a fun musical dealing with.
It really is.
Remember, we're laughing and singing along to this. Marina, how long have you actually been attached to this project for? What's COVID done to
us? Oh, gosh. So it was nearly 2 years ago that we were going to do it and then, of course, everything just stopped. And, look, in every industry, but I think our industry has been decimated because we can't work without an audience, you know.
No.
So, and it doesn't work when you do it on Zoom and all those sort of things.
No.
It's not the same. Theatre is a visceral experience. And I think that's what's going to be gorgeous about this is that there's going to be, you know, 2,000 people a night sitting in a theatre exchanging the fun and the laughter and the energy that we give. And it's a really energetic, it's a very dynamic show.
Yeah.
It's just, I can't wait.
Now, have any of you been lucky enough to meet Dolly yet?
No.
Is that going to happen?
We're hoping.
So.
We're campaigning to get her
in my contract, actually.
Yeah.
But I didn't get
it. What are you campaigning to do, Erin?
We're campaigning to get her over for opening. I feel like it can happen. Borders are opening. We're hoping that everything goes smoothly.
She invented a whole vaccine.
She helped finance.
She wasn't scientifically doing the experiments, but she certainly funded it. You'd think, make
she
the most of it.
She probably has a jet.
Possibly.
Yeah, probably.
I mean, 9 to 5 is a big stop.
Yeah.
It's probably that. Between that and I Will Always Love You, she could probably pay for a jet.
And Jolene.
Yeah. Just thinking about it. There's a jet right there.
Yeah.
Just those three songs.
I think so.
Hey, 9 to 5, the musical, opens February next year, so not long now. That's actually only weeks away.
Yeah.
And tickets are on sale now. Marina, Erin and Casey, it has been gorgeous to talk to you all today.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Can't wait.